Cameroon actor Kankwintos reacts after his film got published on YouTube by a YouTuber without his concern. And his words are, "So yesterday I got an information that someone uploaded the Fisherman's Diary on YouTube and I immediately complained and filed a copyright claim over the person and that account was immediately disabled." And not long ago, after Quintos wrote this on social media, we received a message from the YouTuber pleading and begging Can Quintos to take down the copyright claim, and she was pleading so her channel could be restored. Can Quintos says that this goes as a lesson to others who think that they can actually just sit back at home and play with producers' hard work. Nevertheless, it is not the first time that someone is uploading a content which is not solely theirs without a copyright, without the concern of the producers or the owner of that information. It actually goes as a lesson to whoever is on social media. Before you upload a content on any social media platform, make sure that you have a contact and a relationship with the owner of whatever you are posting on social media. We have information that Can Quintos and this lady are all okay and everything has been settled, and she asked for apologies and she promises never to repeat it again and pleading for her channel to be restored. Can Quintos, on the other hand, being a nice gentleman, is okay and says, "I forgive you, it's fine," and even encourages people to write and to switch to her YouTube channel. We say that Fisherman's Diary has been one of the most outstanding movies in Cameroon, making name not only in Cameroon, but has participated in so many awards, and Can Quintos, not forgetting others who were part of this movie, have received so many awards. And still about the Fisherman's Diary, we talk about the kid actress Faith Fidel, who just won Best Child Actress at the National Film Festival of Ahmednagar in India. She played a remarkable role in the blockbustering movie, which equally won Best Film Award in 2020. We say that, my dear, congratulations to you. You're indeed a little kid, but with a lot of talents in it. And the winners include Can Quintos for Best Actor, Anna John Scott for Best Director, and Ndamo Damaris for Best Actress. We say congratulations to them all. And keep watching The Fisherman's Diary. Indeed, we are proud of Can Quintos and this movie. Still in the nation, from the city of love, United Kingdom, Cameroonian comedian Oboy the Comic sends his love to his fans back at home and keeps saying that, "I can't thank you all so much for your unending love, your unending support when it comes to my comedy and trying to push 237 entertainment industry to another level. I want to assure you that being here in Europe, I am not forgetting where I come from, and I am promising that I am going to create a link between the comedy kids in Cameroon and that in the diaspora, Europe to be precise." Oboy the Comic, we know him to be one of the most renowned comedians in Cameroon, and just not long ago, he left us here in Cameroon and is now based in Europe, where he assures Cameroonians that he is not forgetting where he comes from, and he's assuring all the comedians that whatever you do, you have to do it with a lot of hard work, because wherever he is, he's going to keep supporting 237 comedy, and not just comedy contents, but entertainment contents at large. Cameroonian music diva Nabila has clinched an influential deal with bank company and UBA, and the company is said to have promoted the mobile app and wants Nabila to serve as the face of this mobile app. We know about Nabila. Nabila has done so many songs for us, like songs done for us between her and Tizi Panchak, Trompe. We have other songs done for us by Nabila. And Nabila has been termed one of the most beautiful and most outstanding female artists we have in Cameroon. And just not long ago, she clinched a deal with UBA and standing in as a face of promoting their mobile app. We say that indeed Cameroon showbiz and entertainment industry is actually getting to another level, and we keep saying that, keep striving hard, and indeed hard work pays, and we say congratulations to Nabila. Still in Cameroon, let's talk about Cameroon International Film Festival, CAMIF 2021, which started yesterday, April 19, and will run from the 19th to the 24th of April at the prestigious Boya Mountain Hotel, which will be a colorful and glamorous event. This event this year is going to be made up of cultural values, and on the 22nd of April shall be full of effervescence with the mask of gala. We have film and social cohesion. We have symposium. We have press conference that shall take place on the 23rd of April, powered by the UNDP. The sleek and stylish white party shall take place on the 23rd of April from 6 p.m. CAMIF 2021 shall be once in a lifetime experience, and I'll bet you wouldn't want to miss this opportunity to get equipped with knowledge of film and business with international guests like Nelson Babatope, Netflix acquisitor. We have Ramsey Noah, multi-award winning actor. We have Snipers Mudrop, director of the Bet Digital. We have Jai Katz, general manager, and the film and business workshops, which will take place on the 20th to the 22nd. The film and business workshop shall be coordinated by the CEO of Bliss International Holdings, Mr. Bliss Chichi, from the 20th to the 22nd, and there shall be insightful masterclasses with experienced instructors like Rene Eta, CEO of GOFA. We have he's going to be teaching about cinematography. We have Itambi Delphine, and we have Nkwanya Nkwai for screenwriting. We have Anuren Quenembom for acting, and Neba Lawrence for directing. And note that the event is free and is open for others. As you can see from the pictures, these pictures were taken yesterday at the start of the event. You can see the comedians, the couple. We know about these two couples when it comes to comedy in Cameroon. And we want to say that Kopi and the husband, we say we are proud of you. And as you can see, pictures are showing that this event started on a good foot, and we pray that it continues like this till the end, that is on the 24th of April, with a sweet white party. Remember, it is free and it is open for everyone. You don't have a dime to pay, no one should complain. I do not have my gate fee because it is open for everyone. And we have, not just long ago, we have a post on social media circulating saying that Ramsey Noah dressed to this event yesterday as though he was just walking into a golf competition or was going out for sports. Everyone was not really happy with the way he appeared. Looking at the way our celebrities appeared with lots like Epole Jeffrey and the others in Tambi Delphine, with a lot of graceful outfits. And you see just Ramsey Noah, the award-winning actor that we know everyone was expecting him to appear in a gigantic outfit. We saw something very, 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 very not just usual, but he appears with a very simple outfit, that is a jeans trouser, a t-shirt, and just a little sneakers. And everyone was like, wow, really? Well, others say this is a sign of simplicity. Others say to be a star, to be a money man, you mustn't show it through your outfit. Others, not everyone likes to dress extravagant, and Ramsey Noah has been noted for that. Let's have a little break. We'll be right back to get into our Westin pitch. Stay with us.